We already discussed JavaScript is dynamically typed language. That means we can assign any type of data to a variable. We don't need to specify the type of the data what we are assigning. All we have to do is declare a variable and then assign some data. That's it. We don't specify what is that. When it comes to arrays, we can specify multiple values to a single variable like this. So the moment you specify this, this is an empty array. We can able to store multiple values in data variable here. So all we have to do is at this point of time, the length of the data. So it is having a property that is length. It is going to be zero. Now I wanted to add some more values in it. You can add by using like this, zero, some value, one, some value. We can able to add some data to that. So the index starts from zero and I have to print the length at the end. Yeah. So in the beginning, the length is zero. Now we have the length is two. Let's directly print this data variable itself. You can see that 10 and 20, it got printed. And we can able to assign values then and there itself while defining the array. So let data one is equals to, here I can assign the value 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40. Yes, we can do that. Log data. So it is going to have, I have to print data one. It's going to have 10, 20, 30, 40. So what is the length? We'll have log data one dot length. We'll have the four length. Instead of that, you can also use something called a new array. So this is array constructor. So in this case, you have to use this parenthesis. So you can create array like this, or you can create array like this. If you want to print data one by one, we can use for loop. Let I is equals to, we already discussed, it starts from zero. I equals zero, I less than, now we have to use data dot length. So why we have to use less than, not less than or equals to? It's simple, it starts from zero. And then I plus plus. Here, log data of I. So this will print one by one. So data one of I, isn't it? Yeah, data one dot length, data one here. You can see that it is printing 10, 20, 30, 40. So this is normal for loop. It is iterating over this array using the index number. And we are specifying condition here. We also have something called for of loop and for in loop and for each loop as well. So let us see one by one. So when it comes to for in loop, forget about all this. It is to iterate over objects. We already discussed array is also an object. Yes, this is a constructor and this becomes an object. It's a class kind of thing. So whenever you use new keyword, obviously it is going to return an instance that is an object. So here our object is data one and it can be anything, any variable, and you can use letter, const or var, anything is fine. So if you have any issue, you can use let, no problem at all. The syntax is let some variable in data one. So what this variable represent? It will iterate over this particular object and then get the key. So what is this key? The key is going to be 0, 1, 2, 3 like that. When we print that, the value of k will have 0, 1, 2, 3. You can see that 0, 1, 2, 3. So how to print the values? You have to use data 1 of k. So this will automatically iterate over data one and then print the value. It will iterate for each key of this particular object. Okay. What is the other loop we have? The other loop is for off loop. This is iterator based loop. It will automatically iterate each value, not the key. It is automatically iterate each value for off loop. So in this case, I don't need to use data one of k. I have to directly print this k. So here, this will iterate over keys, but here it will iterate over values. So here it is getting you 0, 1, 2, 3. Here it will give you the values 10, 20, 30, 40. Let us see that. You can see that the last 10, 20, 30, 40. So here I will print only keys. So here k represents key. Here k represent value. For in loop, for off loop. So wherever we have iterator based, array is an iterator, it returns an iterator. We'll have so many values and it returns an iterator. And this one is specially designed to iterate over objects. Now you get it out. Do we have any other thing where we can directly create an object? Yes, we have. What is that? We can create an object by using this symbol. Here you can able to specify some key. Username, admin, password, ASDF. You can specify the object name as user data. Now you can print the data of this using user data of what is the name? Username, user data of what is the key name? Password. It is printing admin and ASDF. So here, username and password are the keys, admin, ASDF are the values. Yes, in object, we'll have properties, methods like that. There are so many, but we'll discuss about that object later. But as of now, we will store data, only data in object, and then we'll see how to iterate over data. So here we have created key and object. So this is like a JSON object, JavaScript object notation. This is an object. The key, it's going to be any string. The value, it can be any type that we have discussed so far. It can be a number, string, undefined, boolean, null, or array, or an object inside of object. It can be anything. So now let's iterate by using this for in loop by applying it on the actual object. So here this is the object, user data. So here, as I told you earlier, for in loop, this k, it can be any variable. Okay, it's not just only k, it can be any variable. This k represents keys. It should print username and password, not the values. Let us see that. It is printing username and password. Earlier, when it is applied on array, it is printing the numbers, but now it is printing the keys. Now, if you wanted to have the values, then I will specify user data of k. That'll be fine. So now it is going to print username, admin, password, ASDF, like this. So using for in loop and for off loop, you can able to iterate over array or over object as well. But do remember, when it comes to for in loop, it is specially designed to iterate over objects. For off loop is to iterate over iterators.